Hello friends, welcome to the video on leaf modifications. It's been long since I made any morphology video. The last one was on compound leaves. You can check it out because there will be some link over here. And anyways, to start with leaf modifications, we have leaf modifications as tendrils, spines, hooks, phyllodes and bladders and pitchers. So let us start with learning these. So tendrils, what are tendrils? Tendrils are thread-like sensitive structures which leaf possesses, and they help the leaf or they help the plant in standing upright. Okay, so as we know, all plants do not possess a hardy and upright stem. Many plants are there which have weak stems, so they have to possess this type of structures to get support on any other plant or any other stick or something, and they can stand upright. Okay, so that's why tendrils come into existence. And we have also studied about thorns, we have also studied about many other types of climbing structures which the plants possess. Anyways, this is not the topic of this video. So there are many types of tendrils. In tendrils there are many types of classifications. Okay, so let us see. I have pictures, so let us study with the help of these pictures. Okay, so first of all let's look at this picture. This is called the leaf apex tendril. So here there is the petiole, there is the leaf, and at the apex of the leaf the apex gets elongated and becomes thread-like, and thread-like and sensitive, so it becomes a tendril after all. And then if there is a structure, there is a plant with an upright stem or a strong stem, it can grab on to that plant and it can grow upright. So that type of tendril is called leaf apex tendril. Then we have this one. Okay, so that is a leaf tendril. What it is? A whole leaf tendril. Okay, so this was a leaf apex tendril. You can see the leaf, but this is a whole leaf tendril. So the whole leaf is modified into a tendril, so you cannot see the broad lamina of the leaf. After all, the whole leaf is modified into this thread like sensitive tendril, and it does the same function. It grabs on to another stick or another strong support and it helps the plant to grow. But over here you can see that there are some stipules over here. So what does this, and these stipules looks like leaves, right? Looks like leaves, but they are not leaves, they are stipules. And what are stipules? They are scaly outgrowth, they are epidermal outgrowths. Okay, so they are outgrowths from the epidermis of the stem, and they are not leaves then. But in case of these type of tendrils, that is the whole leaf tendrils, these stipules only perform the function of photosynthesis. Okay, so let us move on. Next we have this tendril, that is the leaflet tendril. So we have already studied about compound leaves, so we know that all leaves are not a whole leaf. All leaves are not like this. One leaf can have many parts. Okay, so one leaf, this midrib, and there can be incisions on it which reach to the midrib, and they create such compound leaves. We have already studied about this in the previous video, compound leaves. Okay, so now the tendrils are which are going to be formed are modification of these leaflets. Okay, so these small leaves are called leaflets, and the tendrils which are going to be formed are the modifications of these leaflets. Okay, so let me complete it. Here we go. They may or may not be this terminal leaflet, and there are some classifications like parapinnate and all those. So this is not the topic of this video again. So now let us move on to that third picture where this one. So that is a leaflet tendril. So what happens here is that The leaflets gets modified into the tendrils. So we have already studied that this whole leaf can be modified into a tendril, okay, a thread like tendril. So one leaflet may be modified into a tendril and help in climbing. And in this case, since we have so many leaflets in a leaf, so we can choose some more leaflets to get modified into tendrils. Okay, so there can be another classifications, so that are that the terminal leaflet tendrils. Okay, so what happens is that the terminal leaflets are getting modified into tendrils and helping in climbing. Okay, and so this is not the terminal leaflet tendril, sorry, this is the upper leaflet tendril. So the upper leaflets are getting modified and helping in climbing, and the terminal leaflet tendrils is that only one leaflet is getting modified. So these are not getting modified into tendrils, only this one is getting modified into a thread like tendril. And if there is a support over here and it can grab on to that support, coil to that support, because they are sensitive structures, right? So they can coil to the support, they can feel the support, and they can, if they feel the support, they can coil to the support, and then the plant can grow. There will be more such leaf, compound leaves, and more such tendrils, or not only one in the whole plant. That is common sense, right? So that was the leaflet tendrils. Let us look what more are there over here. Now we discuss this one. There are so many pictures, let me give a tick mark on which we have discussed. So this we have discussed, this we have discussed, this we have discussed. Now we move on to this one. So this is the stipular tendrils. Two examples before, we were talking about stipules, which were the epidermis, the stipules which are epidermal outgrowths. So now, and in that example, what happened is that the whole leaf got modified into a tendril, and there were the stipules which performed the function of photosynthesis, right? Because without photosynthesis, the plant will die. It is the only, because it doesn't feed on any other thing. Plants are autotrophic. So if they have to prepare their own food, they need to do photosynthesis or they will starve and die. Anyways, so here in that example, what happened was the leaf got modified into a tendril and the stipules performed the function of photosynthesis. Here what happens is that the stipules get modified into a tendril and the leaf does their usual function, that is photosynthesis. Quite okay. Now let us move on to the next one. This one, what is this? This is the leaflet tendrils we have already discussed. There's the upper leaflet tendrils over here, and that this one was the terminal leaflet tendrils. Okay, we will discuss some examples also after we discuss about the different varieties. These are the upper leaflet tendrils. Okay, now there are petiole tendrils. So what are petioles? Many may have forgotten. So this petiole is the structure which connects the leaf to the stem or the rachis. For a whole leaf, it is called the stem. It is connected to the stem, and for a compound leaf, it is connected to the rachis. Okay, so this structure is called the petiole, and as you may have guessed till now, this structure may also be converted into one tendril. And how it will look like? So there will be, let me undo. So there will be one support, okay, a stick or a support, anything, and then the plant is growing, and there is the tendril, which is a long thread like. It coiled many times, and then we have the leaf. So it looks like that, roughly, very roughly. Okay, so you may have got the general idea. Anyways, let me zoom, means undo again. And that was about the leaf petiole tendrils, and that completes the varieties of tendrils. So let us look at the examples of these, which we have to remember, unfortunately, for many students out there. Okay, So first of all, the leaf apex tendril. So here the leaf apex gets modified into a tendril, and an example can be gloriosa. Okay, so that was one. Gloriosa is the genus, so Gloriosa sp. Then we have the leaf tendril, where the whole leaf gets modified into a tendril, and example over here is the wild pea. So there is the Lathyrus alfaca. So we have the Pisum sativum, that is the sweet pea, and the Pisum sativum is the garden pea, and this is another variety of pea, that is Lathyrus alfaca, and that is the wild pea. Okay, so then we have this one, that is the leaflet tendril. So it can be upper leaflet and it can be the terminal leaflet. So in this case this is the terminal leaflet tendril, and it can be, example is Navelia. Okay, over here we have stipular tendril, example is Mylax. Over here we have leaflet tendrils, the upper leaflet tendrils, example is sweet pea and garden pea. Okay, so scientific name you might already know, that is the Pisum sativum, and the Lathyrus odoratus. That was Lathyrus alfaca, that was the wild pea, and Lathyrus odoratus is the sweet pea. Okay, now over here is the leaf petiole tendrils. So leaf petiole tendrils, examples are garden nasturtium and Nepenthes, the pitcher plant. Okay, so that's interesting, because the pitcher plant contains the leaf modification of a pitcher, as you can see over here, we will be going to discuss later on. And then the connecting, the petiole that connects the pitcher is again modified into a leaf petiole tendril, so it is again modified into a tendril. So a lot of modification for a single plant. Okay, now let us talk about spines. So here I want to introduce a very important differentiation, or very confusing terms. They are, that is, the spines, the thorns, and the scaly outgrowths that comes are the prickles. Okay, so what are the difference? Do you know? Just think for a while. First of all, the difference is that difference in origin. Okay, so as we know that there is again difference between taproot and adventitious root. What is that? The taproot originates from the radical. So there are primule and radical. So the taproot is the true root, but the adventitious root or the fibrous root originates from the base of the stem. So they are not the true root, but they are also root. So like that, there is the difference in origin between the thorn, spine, and prickle. First of all, that difference is that spines, as you may have all guessed till now, is a leaf modification. So it originates from a leaf. So a leaf gets folded and converts into a spine. Okay. Then we have the thorn. It is a stem modification. So a thorn, the stem modification anyways. And then a prickle, that is again like that of the stipule, an epidermal outgrowth. Okay, so examples are also there, but some common ones, commonly whenever we talk about any of those, the spines, the thorn, or a prickle, in our head we imagine some thorny means some pointed structures, okay, which can pinch us anyways. So that are the subtle differences. So prickles are what we observe in rose, okay, and spines in what, cactus. Okay, so anyways, so let us look at it. So here is two examples of different types of spines which are available, like the leaf spines. Like this is the opuntia, the plant opuntia, that is a cactus. Common cactus is known as opuntia, and this is the leaf spine. So in the desert areas, the leaf has a lot of surface area, so it can lose very much water. It can do transpiration, and the plant will lose many very precious water. So to prevent that loss, these leaves are converted into leaf spines, and these phylloclades, means the stem, are going fleshy. becomes a little bit fleshy, and they perform the function of photosynthesis by possessing the chlorophyll. Okay, and then we have this leaf apex spine, which is having the leaf apex as hard and pointy. Okay, so there can be other spines also, like the leaf margin spines, in case of those different type of margins, where these margin has different pointy apexes and they are also acting as spines. And then we have this leaf spine, okay, where one leaf is completely getting modified into a spine. Okay, so that was about spines. Okay, and what is the benefit of having spines? First of all, you have already learned about this open shear, where we are preventing the loss of water, and again we are also defending the plant. Is not we, the plant is also defending itself from predators, because they would definitely not like to predate on such spiny plants. Too bad for their mouths. Okay, anyways, then we have the hooks. What are hooks? Hooks are just again the climbing structures like that of tendrils. So they are not thread like, they are tough structures, and they are like this one. They are curled structures, and they means just like whatever you imagine of the hook, imagine of a hook, and they can be modified, and they are modified leaves, as we are studying it on leaf modifications. So a leaf can be modified into such a structure. So it is not a tendril. Why it is not a tendril? It is not thread like, and it is having this type of shape, and it is again performing the function of grabbing on to any strong support and helping the plant to grow. Okay, so here you can see hooks over here. This one, this is the hook, this is the leaflet hook anyways. Okay, so that was hooks. And then we have, I forgot to mention another modification, that is the root. Okay, so in case of the plant salvia, so that is an aquatic plant, the root, one leaf of every node gets modified into a root. Okay, and that helps in balancing. Anyways, next one is phyllode. Phyllode is a fleshy structure, a fleshy leaf. So what is the difference between phyllode and phylloclad? So phylloclad sounds similar, right? But phylloclad is the modification of a stem, and it becomes fleshy and helps to prevent transpiration. But then phyllode is the modification of a leaf, and it becomes fleshy and looks similar like that of the phylloclad. And it again, when it becomes fleshy, it loses its surface area and again prevents transpiration. And just like these of the looks like these stems, and but they are modified leaves after all. Okay, and then we have these bladders and pitchers. Okay, so that's a very subtle difference again between a bladder and a pitcher, but I have an example. So you can see over here, this one, this picture very accurately shows a bladder. So there are two leaves arranged in such a way that whenever an insect arrives over here, it will close, and then digestive juices will digest that insect. So they are also modified leaves, right? Because these things are leaves after all. And example can be utricularia. And then we have this one, that is the pitcher. Whenever someone enters for some insect enters into it, the lid over here, it is also called the operculum, will close, and the insect will not be able to leave this pitcher. Or a pitcher, what does a pitcher mean? Pitcher means a large jug. Okay, so it looks like a jug, right? So that's why it is called a pitcher. So, and the plant is called pitcher plant. Okay, and it will not be able to leave, and then digestive juices as usually will be thrown over the insect, and the insect will be digested for nitrogen mainly, because these plants are grown on nitrogen deficient soils. Nitrogen is a very important requirement. Many plants use that symbiosis to get nitrogen, and these plants eat insects to get nitrogen. Anyways, so that was all about leaf modifications. Hope you liked the video. Please like, comment and subscribe. Bye.